Welcome back. These are the two remaining chapters on the setup of neural networks in our series on neural networks for architects. If you're at the edge of the world and you want to make differences, looking at the world, you want to make differences, you have to leave linearity. And this is done with two different concepts, which at the end they are the same. But two different concepts represented as specific layers, and we want to discuss them and to get an understanding how to get contracts with your picture sitting at the edge of the world, picturing the world, and you need contrast, and you can only do it with non-linearity. And there's one is a cut and the other is the fold. So this chapter is on the cut, and I will give you some example how it works. Again, we follow our scheme. We have a batch. So we introduce a data which are cut. So, and this is done with, for example, this if statement. If the data, the plus of two numbers is greater than 5, then plus. If the first number is greater than 5, then add these two numbers. If these first is less than 5, subtract these two numbers. So very simple. So then we can have a batch of 10 samples. This is less, so subtract. This is 5, subtract. This is bigger than 5, so therefore add. And if we look at these samples, this is how it looks like. So there's a clear edge. So, and if we have these linear functions, our linear layers are working with, the interesting is, or the challenging, that they can't see this edge, because it's not linear. So let's give a demonstration of it and how to get out of it. So data samples, as we had always. Then we go with the first network as we did before, just for contracting. So we want with two inputs. We have it here. Get rid of this. Two inputs and a scalar as an output. So therefore we have two inputs. We give him some parameters. So 12, 2 by 12, 12 by 12, 12 by 1. So these are our parameters. So it's quite a resolution for a simple problem like that. So then flatten it to make it a scalar. So this is our first network. If we train that, then we take a second network. We call that net one and that net two. And the only difference is between this layer here and this layer here, we put in a ramp. We will see how it works, what it does. So the ramp is something like this. So it simply says if a value is less than zero, it's zero. If it's greater than zero, take the value as it is. So which means he cuts all the things less than zero and forgets them. So it's embedded in all these linear systems here, in this linear setup. Here it is embedded. And by that, where to cut, or how the slope of this edge is, this is to discussion. This is implicit, but it simply introduces a strong cut and say forget the left side. So this is how it is done. Now train these networks. Get with the first one. Net one, data, validation set, data, so this is here what we had. Loss plot, train that. So you see, it's not working. So we have 15% error, and it doesn't get better. So loss of 15. If we do the same thing, and we can show that, get an F1 here, get the input and the output, and then we see he can't get the edge. Yeah? So if we are with linearity, we are out. So if we now take the other set, net 2, with the same data, and do it, and you see it's getting better. It's getting the edge. Now it's struggling around. Now it's getting much better. So there's something, look here. It's like always finding the proper minimum, as we had seen in the big propagation story. Now he gets better. So if we have that, we have this, you see the loss, it's almost zero. And if we render that, we get a proper edge. It's a little smoothing out here, but it's able to see it. Because at the edge of the world, you're beyond linearity, so then you are with, you're out of time. So, and this is how you introduce it into the ratio of these aliens. You have to introduce a nonlinear element always. Doing it, for example, with a ramp. So that's it. You can have it with bigger resolution, but we are already very good here. So that's the ramp. Next will be on the fold, which is the same thing but continuous and gives a better insight of what this cut is about and what the digital is about. That you have to leave the Earth and you have to get alienated beyond linearity if you want to understand what computer science is. Thanks for watching and see you.